people in this deserted village were not here to tell their stories, but the picture on the ground speaks volumes of the devastating consequences of the Anglophone crisis in this locality. On the 6th of May 2018, dozens of houses were set ablaze in Balangi, in Bongay subdivision of Meme, southwest region of Cameroon. This is the aftermath of what occurred. As we can see, this is one of the most visited areas. It was a popular drinking spot here in Balangi. You can see how bottles have been shattered here on the floor as a result of the fire disaster that took place that night. We talked to some local inhabitants who made us to understand that security forces were behind the burning of houses here in Balangi, but we could not independently verify the veracity of this information. On the site of the incinerated structures were burnt household items and other valuables. Most of these roadside structures, which are now in ruins, were business premises and home to dozens whose whereabouts is now unknown. We approached some of the doors, knocked, but no one answered.
This is one of the private residences here in Balangi. We can see that it's been practically deserted. The doors are practically closed and it's almost nightfall. Nobody's here. We can knock and nobody's here to open the doors. And if we keep moving, we'll see that it's a similar scenario almost all over. We cannot tell where the people are or where they actually escaped to. But it's obvious that...
Good evening, everyone. It's almost, it's still very late now. I just had to play that report by Mimi Mefo in Balangi, in the southwest region of Cameroon, for you to know just how far Mimi Mefo has gone to, how far she has gone as far as reporting is concerned in this Anglophone crisis, for you to know where she has gone to, for you to know the interior villages in which she has gone to. She has bypassed bullets. She has climbed mountains. She has gone down valleys. Yes, she has done so many things. But what the government chose to do was to bring out an article that she wrote about the American missionary who was killed in the northwest region of Cameroon. She saw us as family and equally wrote that the another source is CNA. Now, why did the government not go and interrogate the family of the American missionary? If you read the article, it's written there, family sources. But the government now had to, you know, they had to work on that because they knew it was a hot fire. And when I saw that report, I knew that that report was going to bring a problem, because the government has been looking for all means to bring her down. They have been looking for all possible means. Now, I want to let you know that Mimi Mefo has been taken to the New Bell prison. She will be there till Monday. She's expected to appear in court, and it will be the military court on Monday. I just had that information from one of the barristers, Barrister Tamfo Richard, who told me a while ago. And he was heading to New Bell. He was driving to New Bell when I caught him. And he confirmed to me that Mimi Mefo has been taken to New Bell Central Prison in Douala. She will be there till Monday, according to what he told me. And that she's going to appear in court on Monday. That will be next week. The case today, just a rundown of what happened. When they went there and saw the gendarmes and the interrogators, they actually brought out those two articles, fighting between restoration forces and, you know, military in Bamili, as well as a report on the American missionary who was murdered. Now, Mimi Mefo had to defend herself. And there came a point where they asked her some other stuff, and the lawyers had to say no, there she can't say further. You know, in journalism, there are, at a certain point, you have the right to reserve, you know, the source of your information if it's going to be harmful to that person, to your resource person or to your source. Now, after that, the gendarmes had to ask her to sign that document that was going to see her sent to prison. And the lawyers refused that she will not sign that document. Now, I wrote on my Facebook page a while ago, the lawyers had to quote article at section 117 saying that it has no connotation as far as the criminal procedure code is concerned, that they told the gendarmes that it was a civil case, therefore had no connotation for them to send her to jail. And so they had to send them now to the state military prosecutor. That's where everything changed. Now, my question is, how come the state military prosecutor was in the office at 9:30 p.m. What was the state military prosecutor doing there? Did they arrange that if it fails at the level of the gendarmerie, because they knew he came with a battery of lawyers, they were going to definitely come to meet the state military prosecutor? That is a question. That is a question, my dear brothers and sisters. It is the biggest question, and the answers, you have them. How come the state military prosecutor was still in the office until they had to go and discuss for about 1 hour, and she was sent to the New Bell Central Prison? Ladies and gentlemen, it is heartbroken, but it's just like other Anglophone journalists who have been arrested. But this one is particular because she's one of the, a female who has been on the ground. She is someone who has, you know, mastered the Anglophone crisis as far as reporting is concerned. That is why we must stand with Mimi Mefo. We must stand with each and every Anglophone journalist. What is happening? I want to declare here right now that there is one man at Equinox TV. I gave Equinox TV time to bring it out, but yet they have not showed any signs of, you know, of seriousness. This man called Innocent Abega. Get that name very well. This is somebody with whom I have taught the two English-speaking regions with. He was my cameraman. He is the man behind the Insight, the program I left at Equinox. You must have watched the program. Many say it was a nice program when I left it, and still a nice program now. Innocent Abega has been the cameraman. We have gone everywhere. We have interviewed big persons and all, Agbobala and the rest. But behind a nice cameraman was a spy. Behind a nice cameraman was a traitor. Behind a nice cameraman was somebody who could sell you for 30 pieces of silver. Yes. So this is a guy who has been monitoring journalists. You go with him out, he monitors your calls and everything about you. And he comes and gives it to the security militaire Semil. He works for them, he's a correspondent for them. And that is a guy who has been behind Mimi Mefo all the time in the office. Wherever she goes to, Abega will be there just as if he wants to play, do as colleagues. But he's tapping information. Abega should be very careful. I've called your name now because it has reached a limit. I never wanted to call your name. We have had so much as far as working together is concerned at the Equinox. And I left. And before I left, I knew that you, I suspected you, and I even asked you. You laughed. That was then. Now it is very clear that you are a big spy at Equinox TV. And the whole world should bear me witness what I'm saying tonight. If Equinox TV does not interrogate Innocent Abega for what he does to journalists, especially what he has done to Mimi Mefo. People were even surprised in Bonanjo. They asked that, but this Abega, is he a colleague? Because he is the one bringing every information about you here. Remember, 1 month ago, Mimi Mefo was being monitored from office to home. From office, from home to office. Everywhere she went to, you had gendarme vehicles, police vehicles. She'll go at night, she'll meet the police vehicles stationed in front of her home. That is what has been happening, just to traumatize her, just to make her feel traumatized, you know, dejected and everything. So Innocent Abega is the main person who has been giving information to security forces. I say it loud and clear. I don't know how much information he gave about me, but when we went out, I was very tactical in dealing with him. No wonder. When we used to go on mission in the Northwest region, he always answers calls. We AP, we mon commandant. I said to myself, but what type of cameraman is this? Who is, you know, who knows almost everybody in the military, you know? And I must say, there's a picture I took at around hospital roundabout. It's on my wall now. If you see that picture, you see GSO, Groupement Special d'Opération. They are behind me, and I'm reporting on a stand-up. He knew, in fact, he knows almost everybody there in that group, just behind. I was doubting that bed. How come this man knows? And, you know, it's not easy for security people to allow you guys to take videos and all that. I didn't even pictures. When we went on mission, he always say, oh, let's go and meet the governor. I'm somebody, I don't meet an authority because we want to beg for favor or we are, no. The authority needs you, or if you need an interview, you meet the authority. You don't go to a town where you go to meet an authority because you say, oh, Monsieur le Gouverneur knows something. He knows I don't do that rubbish. I will finish, I go to my hotel room, I sleep. So I've noticed him that he always like, let's do this. So that particular person should be, if Equinox TV does not hold Innocent Abega responsible for the arrest of Mimi Mefo, arrest and imprisonment of Mimi Mefo, then in the days ahead, I will launch a second or a third live video on Equinox TV. In particular, I love Equinox. I worked there and they loved me and I left in peace. And if they want that, we should remain in peace. They should take Innocent Abega and interview him. And there must be sanctions, because I say this loud and clear. There must be sanctions against him. Now, secondly, it is very certain that English-speaking journalists are not safe in Cameroon. It is clear we are no more safe in Cameroon. Very certain. Now, what can we do? What can we do when we report, the government will arrest us? When you report the truth, they will intimidate you? I don't know. I don't know what to say, because I'm short of words. I don't know what to say. It's as if English-speaking journalists, especially in the private press, should just abandon the journalism profession and do something else. Yes, that's what the government wants us to do. They want us to abandon and do something else. Nobody's thinking about the vision card. Nobody, they are not thinking about those who have plunged Cameroon into what we have today, into television mingling. They are not thinking about them. No. They are not thinking about those journalists who write fake stories on Hitler and it broad daylight, and once they support the regime, it is good for them. Once they support the regime, it is good for them. Yes, those people who have men in power, ministers and all that, they don't, no. English-speaking journalists, you write, in fact, we are under spyglass. You write an article, they follow you up. I remember there was an article written in the Sun newspaper about the attack of the army chief of staff in Le BLM. They called them in Yaoundé. And questioned them. It was true. He was attacked. But they called them in Yaoundé and questioned them. Intimidate them. So there is an attack. Nobody should write about that attack, because you want to save somebody. We of the English-speaking journalists in Cameroon, we don't do that. We report what we see. Yes. Somebody said I should show his picture. I've called his name. You go to Facebook and see his name. I've called his name, and I'm not afraid to call his name 100 times, because enough is enough. Enough is enough. Like I was saying, we don't report like that. We report the truth, and the truth shall set us free. We have reported the truth, and we'll keep on reporting the truth. Journalism is not a crime. Free Mimi Mefo, even before Monday. Journalism is not a crime. Today, in Dar es Salaam, in Tanzania, the African head of Committee to Protect Journalists, Angela Quintal, she always comments on my Facebook page. She was arrested by the Tanzanian government. CPJ had released a document asking the Cameroon government to stop intimidating Mimi Mefo. She was arrested today. What is happening? What is happening to journalism? What is happening? The government should free Mimi Mefo. Because at the time when journalists will rise up, They will start seeing us as activists and terrorists. Because when people keep calm, when journalists keep calm, they say we'll do our profession as journalists while respecting the deontology of this profession, the ethics. We'll do our profession, we'll criticize, but criticize in a mature way, yes. We'll write stories in a mature way. We'll not write stories like what the people of the other side write and collect money. When we do that, they say, oh, those people, they are snails, it's unfair. No, we are not weak. We are not weak. I, for one, am not weak. I am not weak. If I was able to tap some intelligence about the case against three of us, myself, Mimi Mefo, and Derek Jato, it shows that we were not sleeping. And that's what they were planning to do to me. That's what they were planning to do to me. They planned to take me not even to a court, to beat me up like 3 days, keep me, and I will just be confused. Yes, we know all the plans. And the plan against Mimi Mefo overturned. Her initial plan was just to take her like 7 hours, interrogate her. Now the American missionary article brought up, was a damaging one against Mimi Mefo. I don't know why, I don't know how, because investigations are still going on. But many persons are saying he was killed by soldiers. And the family with whom we quoted said he was killed by soldiers. Ladies and gentlemen, the imprisonment of Mimi Mefo, dear English-speaking journalists, should be a wake-up call to all of us. It should be a wake-up call that you who is working with that governor, you who is working with the mayor, you who is working with that minister, you who is working with that director, you are not safe. That you think that you are covered, you are not covered, you are not safe. It should be a wake-up call for all of us to stand as one. If all of us stand as one, the government will stop this intimidation. If all of us stand as one people, one person, one power, the government will stop this intimidation. If we all of us carry one headline, 10 newspapers in the English-speaking region, or 10 newspapers in Southern Cameroon, I like to call it that way, because they are pushing us to the wall, and they don't know how. Some English-speaking journalists are, they don't know. They are pushing us to the wall. If all of us write 10 headlines that will carry the same 10, the same stories, the same headlines, they will know that we mean business. Yes, they are always very happy when we are in this array. Ladies and gentlemen, my fellow English-speaking journalists, it shouldn't relent your efforts in writing the truth. Nothing else but the truth, even in times like this. Yes, I've seen it. I've lived it. I've even missed bullets. Yes, in the Northwest on the 13th of January 2017, I missed bullets when GSO shot 4 times and it touched 4 motorbikers, motorbike riders. I was in front of them on a bike. I missed bullets. I've seen them. I've picked stones in the Northwest. When I showed my badge as a journalist, they said I must pick a stone. Because when those guys came in on the 9th of January 2017, when they blocked travelers and they went, when the military came, I was the only one on that street. They said I must pick the stones. I said I was not the one who threw the stone. They said, no, I must pick them. So I've picked stones, I've seen several things on the ground. I know what I'm talking about. And if today I decided to escape, it is because a lot of people spoke to me. Family members, people cried that they were seeing something coming. I had not planned to leave Cameroon. Yes, you should know today. You are looking for me, yes. You will not see me there. I had not planned to leave Cameroon. A lot of people spoke to me. A lot of people cried. I've lost several things because we want the truth. But today you stand to imprison somebody who is speaking the truth, who writes the truth. You stand to imprison someone who who has shown us that she can balance the story. She was there and interviewed presidential candidate. Today you call her a secessionist and a terrorist, when definitely she showed the whole world that she could write stories. Go on the wall of Mimimefo. Just read Mimimefo info. She writes everything concerning the government and concerning the Southern Cameroon. Where has she gone wrong? Where has she gone wrong? I should be the one to say today that 80% of my articles are on the crisis. Yes, Mimimefo writes on both sides 50-50. Don't arrest Mimimefo today to say she's a terrorist. You plan it to arrest her. You plan to arrest Mimimefo, lock her up. You plan to destroy her career. But God does not sleep. He is not sleeping. Release Mimimefo before Monday. If you take Mimimefo to the military court, that is a gagging on the press. Let's stand as one. This fight has just started. Journalism is not a crime. English-speaking journalists have the right to exercise their duties wherever they go to. They have the right to exercise their duties, and they are going to exercise their duties. One day is one day. Cameroon is our country. We will come back. And it will not be easy. It will not be easy. By then, when we come back, we don't even know what will happen. Maybe then we'll be asked to give to have new passports. Because who knows tomorrow? Who knows tomorrow? That is why today, if you are big, you are a big man and you're eating, make sure you give your servant something good, because nobody knows tomorrow. We might come back tomorrow with different passports. It's very possible. It's very possible. Because the Cameroon government, you are pushing English-speaking journalists to the wall. In fact, you have pushed us to the wall. We are terrorists. We have been brandished terrorists everywhere. We are terrorists. We are supporting Amber. We are doing this. You want to arrest everybody? Makati is there. He has spent over 8 months in at the Bamenda Central Prison. 6 journalists were yesterday. Went yesterday to the military court. You have Majo BBC in court. You have the former Equinox TV journalist. You have about 20 English-speaking journalists who have been involved in this crisis, who have been arrested. What have we done wrong to the Cameroon government? Where did we go wrong? You arrested on the 9th of February about 9 English-speaking journalists in 2017. Where did we go wrong? Where did we go wrong? What have we done? The future is pregnant. Thank you.